separating. So this is such desire which can be even that dangerous. So how to make somebody feel important? Now, sometimes what happens is now we know that we have to make somebody feel important. What we will do, we will just start appreciating that person. So there are certain rules that we have to follow as the book suggests. It says that do not flatter, because the definition of flattering is when you appreciate somebody, the difference between flattery and a real appreciation is that when you appreciate somebody, you appreciate on what you think about that person. When you flatter somebody, you repeat things what you think that person is thinking about herself or himself. So it should be a genuine appreciation. Now, a lot of positive and negative things will happen, but you still will have to find the good things, find the right things, and then appreciate that person, what you think about that. That is where you apply the attitude of gratitude, where you apply continuously looking at good things in that person. And that is how you will be able to make that person feel good, make that person feel important, and that person will have that hunger. That person will have that aroused hunger to be with you, to be connected with you. And that's how that person will do something for you. That ends my topic for today. But I'm going to share more in next week, because there is so much to learn. And I'm sure everybody can apply that. Thank you so much. And it was nice sharing.
Thank you, Madhvi. Thank you for a great start for the book club. Genuine appreciation is very important for everyone, because sometimes, you know, people don't get enough money. But then if you really genuinely appreciate about their work, they will outperform. Wonderful. Thank you so much. So we'll go to the next speaker. Chahak, you can go ahead.
I will be the next after someone else.
Cool.
My name is Arun. I have about 13 years of experience in HR and corporate field. And I'm from Bangalore. And today I'm going to speak about a topic from Magic of Thinking Big. This is goals, goal allows you to grow, right? So we all know that without goals, we cannot grow. And so goal is an objective. It is a purpose, right? So it is, it is a dream. So anyone, for that matter, whoever is successful, be it a cricket player like Sachin Tendulkar, or it could be, the PV Sindhu, who is the badminton player, there is a dream, there is a passion behind their success. So the goal is very important, and they would have nurtured this seed, very early, and that's how they work towards it. So nothing happens when we don't move and think with any forward steps towards the goal, whatever we have thought. And so once you start moving ahead, that's how the goal is achieved. So we need to start thinking about this goal on a larger perspective, start visualizing the goal. So there could be three aspects which an individual can think about his goal. So one is on the work front, on the professional side, and the other is on the personal, which is home. And the third one is the social. So on the work front, the individual has to have a goal on what is the income level he would want to attain. Now, what is that income? Maybe next 5 years, I want to achieve an annual income of about 50 lakh. So I need to start visualizing that from right now. And what is the level I want to achieve? Maybe I want to lead a team, a larger team on the work side. And on the home, on the personal side, with my family, what is the standard of living I want to provide for my family and myself? Okay. Social, what kind of friends I want to have? On the society, what kind of friends maybe I want to I could take an example of this book club. It's a community where I'm learning, and I'm also sharing few things of my learning. So that's a goal which I need to consciously decide on what is that I want to choose. And when you surrender to your goal, the goal works for yourself. It subconsciously works within you, and it becomes consciously, you start working on it without any additional effort. And it's good to set hourly goals. For example, it could be anything. Most of the people start thinking negative, start talking negative. Most of them are used to get into gossip. So we can set a short goal, maybe for 1 hour, maybe between 11 to 12 in the morning that I'm not going to talk anything negative and I'm not going to have any gossip about anyone. So that's a short goal. And so these things can achieve in the long term. And the important thing is, you know, it's not where you were or where you are, but where you want to get. So that's a very important food for thought if you want to grow and achieve achieve your dream. And we must invest in ourselves, you know. We must invest in self-education. That's how I think you can achieve a goal. And I'm happy to be part of this book club. And this is one of the goals which has helping me to learn and then grow. Thanks for the opportunity, Kiran. And I look forward to share more the next week.
Wonderful, Arun. Really, really nicely you summarize the chapter. You know, use goals to overcome fear and use goals to achieve your dreams. Very nice. Cool. So we'll move to the next speaker. Sasi, you can go ahead.
Hi, Kiran. Can you able to hear my voice?
Yeah, we can hear you, Sasi.
Yeah, thanks, Kiran. So thanks, Kiran, for giving me this opportunity. And today my outline of topic is habits between rich and poor people. The source of points taken from the Rich Dad and Poor Dad book, and the other name was like Robert Kiyosaki. Special thanks to the Bharat for recommending me this book to me. Let me take one example and summarize the book. There are two friends, Ramesh and Suresh. Both are working in same company, same designation, and same salary. When salary was credit in their accounts at the time, Ramesh was very much interested in movies, new clothes, parties, new gadgets, etc., which would make him feel rich. He was not able to understand that these all things are liabilities which are not generating any income, and their value will be depreciated also. Whereas Suresh was a different person. He would buy only necessary things and rest of the amount was invested in develop his skills than in stocks, real estate, something like that. After some years, Suresh became a millionaire, whereas Ramesh is blaming his salary and it was the reason for his being in middle class. I will explain you the difference between the poor, middle and rich people mentality. For poor people, after receiving salary, he receives a message on his mobile like credit card amount has been deducted, electricity bill, mobile bill, and other miscellaneous expenditures. If you consider the middle class people, cash flow is slightly different. They receive the salary and all amounts are spent on their expenditures and liabilities. They're thinking that their house is their biggest asset, but it is not an asset until it generates the revenue. If you talk about the rich people, they invest their amount in assets and generating the income. This excess amount they are using for their day-to-day expenses, that is the main reason behind their richness. Remember one thing, it's not the important that is how much you earn. How you use that money is more important than it. Main problem is our thought process. It is like consumer. We have to change that our think like an investor. Everyone is complaining about the reasons for being in a worse situation. It's like a low salary, and if salary is increases, then their life will become like a smooth. But the fact is, if your salary increases, expenses will also increase simultaneously, because higher salary will motivate you to spend more like on cell phones, car, bike, big houses, something like that, which are complete like a liabilities. Last but not least, listening is more important than talking. If that was not true, God would not have given us 2 ears and only one mouth. Yeah. Thanks for Kiran. I'm done with my session. Yeah.
Very nicely you narrated the summary, Sashi. Very nice. Is it the first chapter, Sashi, you're talking?
Yes, Kiran. This is the first time I'm talking.
Awesome. Very nice. Very nicely you shared. Wonderful, man.
Thanks.
Great. So we'll move to the next speaker. Lalita ji. ललिता जी आप बोलेंगे
जी किरण जी
हाँ
किरण जी वीडियो ऑन नहीं कर सकती बिकॉज यहाँ पे बारिश हो रही है
कोई नहीं गो
थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम हेलो एवरीवन दिस इज ललिता बाय प्रोफेशन आई एम अ टीचर एंड टुडेज माय टॉपिक इज 10 क्वालिटीज ऑफ इफेक्टिव लीडर हम सब कहीं ना कहीं एज अ लीडर रोल प्ले करते हैं चाहे वो हमारा हाउस हो हमारा ऑफिस हो या फिर हमारा बिजनेस तो सबसे पहले तो हमें ये जानना होगा कि लीडर क्या है, क्योंकि क्या होता है ना कि हम कहीं भी अपना हमेशा हम अपना सजेशन देते हैं हर जगह और हमें लगता है कि हम लीडर हैं, बिकॉज ऐसा नहीं होता है। हमें जानना पड़ेगा कि लीडरशिप की क्वालिटी क्या होती है एक्चुअली में। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, फर्स्ट क्वालिटी इज द इफेक्टिव लीडर इज ऑनेस्टी, क्योंकि अगर लीडर ऑनेस्ट होता है तो उससे क्या होता है कि उसके टीम मेंबर्स जो होते हैं वो उस पर बहुत ज्यादा बिलीव करते हैं, और यही ऑनेस्टी ही होती है जो उसके टीम मेंबर्स और एक लीडर के बीच की बहुत मजबूत कड़ी होती है, जो दोनों को, दोनों के बीच में रिलेशनशिप को स्ट्रॉन्ग बनाए रखती है। क्योंकि लीडर को हमेशा अपने वर्क के लिए, अपने गोल के लिए, कमिटमेंट के लिए ऑनेस्ट होना चाहिए, क्योंकि कहा भी जाता है कि ऑनेस्टी इज द फाउंडेशन ऑफ लीडरशिप। सेकेंड थिंग इज द कॉन्फिडेंस। कॉन्फिडेंस बहुत ही जरूरी है, बिकॉज अगर एक लीडर के अंदर कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं है तो उसकी बात कोई नहीं सुनेगा, ना तो वो अच्छे से टीम को हैंडल कर पाएगा और ना ही कभी भी कोई भी गोल अचीव कर पाएगा। बिकॉज क्या होता है कि बिना कॉन्फिडेंस वाला जो लीडर होता है वो उस वैन के व्हील की जैसे होता है, जिसमें एयर नहीं होती है तो उसकी वो गाड़ी चल नहीं सकती। ऐसे ही अगर एक लीडर के अंदर कॉन्फिडेंस नहीं होता है तो वो अपने एरिया में सक्सेस नहीं हो सकता। नेक्स्ट इज ओपन माइंडेड। हर लीडर को ओपन माइंडेड होना चाहिए, रिस्क लेना चाहिए, नई नई चीजों को ट्राई करना चाहिए। और अगर कोई ऐसा लीडर होता है जो हमेशा सेफ जोन में रह करके काम करना चाहता है, वो कभी रिस्क नहीं लेना चाहता, तो वो कभी भी ओपन माइंडेड नहीं है। और जो लीडर न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी को हमेशा रिसर्च करता है और उसको अप्लाई करता है, अपने टीम को भी बताता है और टीम मेंबर्स के साथ में हमेशा काम करता है और उन्हें एक्साइटेड रखता है, तो उसकी टीम बहुत ज्यादा ग्रो करती है। तो ओपन माइंडेड होना बहुत जरूरी है। नेक्स्ट है विजनरी। एक अच्छा लीडर जो होता है ना वो विजनरी होता है, क्योंकि वो हमेशा फ्यूचर के बारे में सोचता है, अपने अपने टीम को लेकर के, कि मेरी टीम नेक्स्ट ईयर कहाँ होगी, कैसे उसका ग्रो होगा, नेक्स्ट गोल क्या होगा, ये उसके माइंड में हमेशा चलता रहता है। क्योंकि लीडरशिप में विजन उतना ही ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है जितना खाने में सॉल्ट। जैसे कोई भी अच्छी डिश हो, अगर उसमें सॉल्ट नहीं होगा तो वो टेस्टलेस होगा। सेम ऐसे ही होता है, अगर लीडर के अंदर विजन नहीं है तो वो कभी भी सस्टेन नहीं कर पाता है ज्यादा दिन तक। फिर नेक्स्ट है क्रिएटिविटी एंड इनोवेशन। ये जो क्रिएटिविटी है ये लीडरशिप की बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट क्वालिटी है, क्योंकि क्रिएटिविटी ही एक ऐसी क्वालिटी है जो टीम को एक्साइटेड रखती है। इससे क्या होता है कि प्रोडक्टिविटी भी बूस्ट होती है, और अगर प्रोडक्टिविटी बूस्ट होती है तो डेफिनेटली हम किसी भी गोल को अचीव करने में सक्सेस हो जाते हैं। और इनोवेशन क्या होता है, इनोवेशन वो चीज होती है जो लीडर्स और फॉलोअर्स के बीच में डिफरेंस क्रिएट करती है, क्योंकि जो इनोवेटिव होते हैं वो हमेशा लीडर होते हैं, बाकी सब क्या होते हैं, फॉलोअर्स होते हैं। तो लीडर वही होगा जो इनोवेटिव होगा। नेक्स्ट है अकाउंटेबिलिटी। अकाउंटेबिलिटी एक अच्छे लीडर की पहचान होती है। वह कभी भी अनसक्सेस होता है, जब एक लीडर की टीम अनसक्सेस होती है, लीडर अनसक्सेस होता है तो वो कभी भी ये नहीं बोलता कि मेरे टीम की वजह से मैं अनसक्सेस हुआ हूँ। वो हमेशा अनसक्सेस की पूरी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी खुद के ऊपर लेता है, और अगर सक्सेस होता है तो पूरी टीम को क्रेडिट देता है। तो इस टाइप से जो एक अच्छा लीडर होता है उसके अंदर ये क्वालिटी होती है। नेक्स्ट इज डिसीजन मेकिंग कैपेबिलिटी। जो डिसीजन मेकिंग कैपेबिलिटी है वो तो बहुत ही ज्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है एक लीडर्स के अंदर, बिकॉज अगर आप में क्विक डिसीजन लेने की कैपेबिलिटी नहीं है तो आप अपने टीम में ग्रो नहीं कर पाते हो। और अगर आपका टीम आप अपने डिसीजन को बार बार चेंज करते हो तो आपके टीम मेंबर्स का ट्रस्ट नहीं होता है आप में, तो ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। नेक्स्ट है लिसनिंग स्किल्स, क्योंकि मोस्ट ऑफ लीडर्स जो होते हैं वो क्या सोचते हैं कि लोग मेरी सुने, बट ऐसा नहीं होता कि लीडर हमेशा सही हो, इसलिए उसके अंदर लिसनिंग स्किल्स होना बहुत जरूरी है, बिकॉज उसे अपने टीम मेंबर्स का कभी ना कभी सुनना पड़ता है, उनकी राय लेनी पड़ती है, और जो अपने टीम मेंबर्स का सुन करके उनकी राय लेकर के आगे बढ़ता है तो वो हमेशा ग्रो करता है। नेक्स्ट है ट्रांसपेरेंसी। ट्रांसपेरेंसी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, अगर हम ट्रांसपेरेंट है अपने टीम मेंबर्स के साथ में तो उनका हमारे ऊपर ट्रस्ट होता है और हमारे लिए हमेशा पॉजिटिव फीलिंग्स होती है, इसमें कोई डाउट नहीं होता है, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। नेक्स्ट है इमोशनल इंटेलिजेंस। एक अच्छे लीडर्स के पास अगर इंटेलिजेंट क्वालिटी के साथ साथ में इमोशनल क्वालिटी भी हो तो वो बहुत ही अच्छी बात होती है, बिकॉज इससे क्या होता है कि टीम मेंबर्स से उसका अच्छा अटैचमेंट होता है, इमोशनल अटैचमेंट होता है, और जब हमारा किसी से इमोशनल अटैचमेंट होता है तो हम कभी भी उसको छोड़ते नहीं है, क्योंकि वो हमसे दिल से कनेक्ट हो जाता है। तो इस तरीके से अपने टीम को साथ साथ लेकर चलने के लिए सारे स्किल्स बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होते हैं एज अ लीडर। थैंक यू किरण जी, थैंक यू।
Thank you so much, Lalita ji. I think you have covered so many important points. I think the question is that kitno ne note kiya aur kitno ne apne aap ko reflect kiya. No, you don't have to answer us, but you know, I really liked innovation, accountability, decision making, listening, transparency. Especially, I loved emotional intelligence. How many of us really are emotionally intelligent? And emotionally intelligent ka matlab ये तो नहीं होता ना कि वी आर ओनली इमोशनली स्ट्रॉन्ग, बट वी आर एम्पैथेटिक, लोगों के प्रॉब्लम को समझ पा रहे हैं, बट स्टिल वी हेल्प देम टू ओवरकम द चैलेंजेस एंड क्रिएट अ वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग बॉन्ड विद ईच अदर। एंड हाउ मेनी ऑफ आर रियली इंटेलिजेंट, इमोशनली इंटेलिजेंट व्हेन इट कम्स टू टफ टाइम्स। द वेरी गुड पॉइंट्स ललिता जी, आपने बहुत अच्छे से शेयर किया है, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर शेयरिंग, ग्रेट। सो विल मूव, बिफोर मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर, इफ एनीवन इज जॉइनिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम विल जस्ट टेक अ शॉर्ट इंट्रो, अगर आपका कोई मिस हो, आई थिंक मोस्ट ऑफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी इंट्रोड्यूस्ड। I personally know most of them, except a couple of, you know, I think. If anyone has missed out for introduction, they can unmute and speak, or else at least they can raise a hand. We can take you in between. I think most of you have already introduced. Cool. So we'll move to the next speaker then. Chahak, you can go ahead, yeah.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, Chahak, yeah, you're audible and visible.
Yeah, okay, thank you. So thank you, Lalita. Good evening, everyone. I am Chet. I am pursuing a PGDM from Taxila Business School, Jaipur. Right now, I am in my hometown, Balaghat, Madhya Pradesh. And first of all, thank you so much, Lalita ji, for introducing me to such a great book club. There is a lot of listening, learnings here, and a lot of new things are coming in my ways after hearing you all the great speakers. And thank you, Kiran ji, for providing such a great platform to us. So my topic is how to develop the power of belief from the book, The Magic of Thinking Big. So basically, if we talk about the belief, then first of all, you should have belief in yourself, then you can achieve anything. To achieve anything, you have to make a small goals in your life. By achieving these small goals, you can create a confidence in yourself. And this is one of the kind of belief that you can achieve to a bigger goal. So talking about the points from the book is that belief is an essential ingredient in success. Like belief in great result is the driving force. The power behind all great books, plays, scientific discoveries. So and think success, don't feel failure. If you think positive, then your mind gives signals for the positive outcomes. And if in the same like every coin has a two face, one is head or one is tail. If you are moving in a positive direction, then there is a chances of great success in your life. Like for example, MS Dhoni. We all know that MS Dhoni is a great finisher in all the format. He has a belief that he can hit a six in the last ball, and most of the times he has succeeded in his effort. So it is one of the best example we can relate how we can develop the power of belief. Then develop a skill that you are better than you think you are. Most of the time, sometimes we feel that if we don't achieve something in our life, then we feel demotivated. And this is the reason why we are unable to get the things properly. And so don't feel that you can't achieve anything in your life. If you are feeling that I can achieve this, I can achieve something, then you will be able to create a path for that achievement. And most important thing is believe big. If you are believing big, then you are thinking big, and if you are thinking big, then you are trying to making the path so that you can achieve the big goals in your life. At last, I would like to conclude that believe in yourself and the good start do and the good things do start happening, and a person is a product of his own thought. थैंक यू सो मच.
वंडरफुल वंडरफुल शेयरिंग चहक, बहुत अच्छे से आपने समराइज किया है. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर शेयरिंग द टॉपिक. ग्रेट वंडरफुल. एमएस धोनी का तो एग्जांपल बहुत अच्छा था, पर्सनली माय फेवरेट.
राइट ऑन टाइम टू. एक्सीलेंट.
ऑसम. गुड यार. ग्रेट.
थैंक यू सो मच.
ऑसम. सो वी विल मूव टू द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर. लेट मी डू वन थिंग. मैं ही जाता हूँ. लेट मी स्पीक. आई एम सो एक्साइटेड टू स्पीक. ओके. कैन पीपल सी मी? या okay. Is my voice clear to everyone? I think anyone can confirm.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So guys, if you remember what I spoke last time, you know, I'll just let me summarize. The spotlight effect, right? We spoke about spotlight effect, how we miss out the nitty-gritties around information without looking the overall picture, we take a decision. Today I have got you something very interesting to really see who are the four villains of decision making. And before that, you know, let me ask you a question. Did you know who invented or who discovered oxygen? Did you know who discovered carbon monoxide or, you know, ammonium, or who discovered your soda water? You know, you drink Coke, carbonated water, so many things, right? Who exactly invented or who exactly discovered? Let me tell you the person's name. The person's name is Joseph Priestley. And you know, Joseph Priestley was a person who was mind behind it. And it was around fall of 1772. He was in a situation, with a very critical situation financially. And he used to live in Leeds in England. And at that time, you know, he was very talented person. He was a chemist. He was a scientist, as I already told what and all he invented. And he was also a philosopher and, you know, inventor. He used to priest in ministry. He was also minister in one of the church. And he was a very philanthropic guy. At that time, you know, he had 8 kids. 8 बच्चे थे उसके और उसके पास पैसा नहीं था. उसको 100 pounds मिलते थे सैलरी एंड ही वॉज अ क्राइसिस टाइम कि उसको लगता था यार कैसे सर्वाइव करूंगा. आई नीड मोर मनी. एंड दैट इज वेन ही वॉज लुकिंग फॉर मल्टीपल ऑप्शन गाइज. एंड यू नो वॉट हैपन आफ्टर दैट. ही लुक फॉर मल्टीपल ऑप्शन एंड एट दैट टाइम वॉट हैपन. ही यूज टू बी वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट हिमसेल्फ. सो देर वॉज अ फ्रेंच रेवोल्यूशन गोइंग ऑन. यूज टू सपोर्ट फ्रेंच. सो द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ यू नो लीड्स थ्रोड हिम आउट. सो वेंट टू लंडन एंड देन फाइनली सडनली यूएस. And in the journey of, you know, this journey, there was a Lord, you know, Shelburne. Lord Shelburne was a very renowned person in, you know, England. And Lord Shelburne was recently widowed and he wanted someone to tutor his children. And what happened, you know, Joseph offered the tutoring, you know, capabilities. And Lord Shelburne offered him £250 per year. Now, just give a similar scenario. He offered 150% hike to that guy. The moment 150% hike mila, you know, Joseph to pura khush ho gaya. He was so happy. Yaar, abhi to milega hi milega. I will definitely go it. But he did very smart move. Before jumping to the offer, he just stepped back and took pretty much 4 important steps to take a decision. Let me, you know, summarize that what he did. And before taking his own decisions, the steps, he actually connected with his friend who was Benjamin Franklin. Benjamin Franklin उस जमाने में electricity का काम करता था and he was a very good colleague to Joseph उस time पे. And he asked Benjamin, how should I take the decision? You know, like every one of us asked one of our friends or colleagues. And Benjamin told, you know, do a very simple thing. You do write the pros, write the cons, and then see what it is. And the moment he wrote pros and cons, the pros are always money in the top. And the cons are so many things. You know, he might have to travel to other cities. He might have to, you know, do multiple late night work. So many other things was there. And now Joseph was very confused. Kya decision le kaise? And listen carefully, guys. This is what the 4 steps he took. Now, the first step he did is he rejected the narrow frame. What does it mean? He thought, should I take this offer or not? If it is for money, why don't I look for better options? Why don't I look for, you know, doing some, you know, part-time business or part-time, you know, coaching, part-time speaking profession? He had kept that options open. But then he negotiated with Lord Shelburne for a better package there. So that was first thing is he never jumped into conclusion. Rather, he rejected the narrow frame. The second, he dodged the confirmation bias. You know, early in the process, what happened? Priestley received a strong letter from a friend who argued and who criticized Lord Shelburne's offer. He used to tell ki bhai tera self respect chal jayega, tu uske niche kaam mat kar, bhai tu apna respect ko bacha, you know, kyun kisi ke upar depend karna, you work on his own, and he's not a good person. Lot of people criticized Lord Shelburne, but Joseph did not listen. He was about to listen and say no, but wo listen nahi karta. Rather, he stepped back and tried to find the right information. He talks to many people who knew Shelburne personally, and he actually found out that Shelburne was a very good person. And that is when he dodged the confirmation bias. The moment he knows Shelburne was a good person from the right sources, he considered the offer the next step. The third was he actually distanced himself from his short-term emotions. बहुत बार हम लोग क्या करते हैं, we are always run after money, and after offering 150% hike, he was about to accept the offer, but then he removed his short-term feeling and thought about long-term. मेरे सपने क्या है, मेरे aspirations क्या है, what are the two factors he cared about? And he realized his family's welfare, his family's security, and his financial scholarly independence. ये दो चीज मुझे चाहिए मेरे offer में. अगर ये दो चीज मिल गया, then I'll accept it. That is when, you know, he came out of the short-term emotions. And the last and final, he avoided overconfidence. Even after these three steps, he was about to take offer. He was not overconfident to just say yes. Rather, he negotiated with Lord Shelburne to give him a royalty income of £200 forever life. उसने बोला, जब तक आप मुझे £200 मुझे हर साल नहीं दोगे, तब तक मैं काम नहीं करूंगा. And you know what happened? The moment these four satisfied, he accepted the offer and he worked for Lord Shelburne for 7 years. And even after he quit the job, after 7 years, he still made £200 all his life because of the right approach of making his decision. So guys, this is what I wanted to share with Joseph's story. I am sure you could take some feedback. But before I wind up, let me summarize for you all so that you can see and learn a little bit. So this is a basic summary. The don't, narrow framing, confirmation bias, short-term emotions, and overconfidence. What are the do's? You widen your options. Reality, test your assumptions, attain the distance, and prepare to be wrong. And you can remember these do's by mnemonic, WRAP. RAP is something mnemonic which will help you to remember. And whenever you take any decision in life, apply and let me know, because I have applied and it works like magic. You should also apply in your life, and that is where the real growth happens. Thank you so much, guys. It was really wonderful talking to you. Cool. So we'll move to the next speaker then. Rohit, you can go ahead then.
Hi. Good evening, everyone. I'm Rohit Sharma, and I've graduated from NIT Bhopal in 2015, and I've been working for Ericsson Bangalore for past 5 years. Okay. So my today's topic is from a book of Robert T. Kiyosaki, Rich Dad and Poor Dad. Okay. So I will be focusing on first half of the third topic, that is mind your own business. Okay. So there are two parts basically. First part is mind your own business, and second part is financial struggling. Okay. So I will be covering first half, and next week I will be covering the other half. Okay. So in the first half, he talk about how people, don't mind their own business, how they should mind their own business. He took an example of this guy. I don't remember the name. Ray Kroc. Okay. So Ray Kroc, he was speaking at University of Texas, and he was speaking about the, goals and all these things. After the class, he came out of the class, and, some of the student asked him, like, can you please join us with a beer? So he gracefully accepted and say, okay, I'll join, no problem. So he was having beer with those people, with those MBA students. And so suddenly he asked, do you know what is my business? Right? Ray Kroc, he's a founder and, basically CEO. At that time, he was a CEO of McDonald's. Okay. So everyone knew about this, right? He's a CEO of the McDonald's, all these things. People don't know what was his real, business. So everyone said that who doesn't know that your business is McDonald's. You sell burgers and French fries, all these things. So he said, no, it's not my business. And after some time, he told that, my real business is real estate. Okay. And at that time, very few people know that he actually worked for real estate. And then he explained the scenario, how he got into the real estate. So he said that, whoever is taking the franchisee for the McDonald's, they also need to buy the property under the Ray Kroc organization for the same building, right? That building you will be using for your franchisee, McDonald's franchisee. Okay. So that was his plan. Can you imagine, can you think about this? Very less people in this world think like that. They think, okay, this is my business, I do like that. But he think something, you know, differently. Like he think, okay, if I'm giving my franchisee to you, after some time, maybe you decided to use that same building for some other purpose, then my brand name will be gone, right? Because some people, like after some year, people say, okay, yaar, udhar chala ja, udhar hai na McDonald's, right? But what you have done, you have changed his position, right? So he changed, changed this idea, and he thought that why not I should own the building. So he implemented that, okay? So same thing is applied in our own life. We work for our job. We work for someone else's dream. We work for our bank who hold our mortgage, and we also work for the government, right? We pay taxes, all those things, GST and everything, right? But we doesn't work for ourselves, right? We should work for ourselves also. So this is in this topic he talks about that. He also took one more example where he asked some people, what is your business? So he told, I'm a banker. So he asked, like this author asked, do you own the bank? He said no. Then he asked, why are you saying that you are your business is banking? You are a banker. You work for bank. You do not own the bank, right? So he said, okay, people often confuse between your profession and your business. Okay, your business is something that you do for yourself. You build your asset, but your profession is something that you work for somebody else. Okay, so this was whole from my side today. This was my first topic, and the first time I'm explaining. I'm briefing about the book. Maybe it will be better from next time. Thank you, Kiran. Thank you. Everyone for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Wonderful, Rohit. In fact, I didn't feel like it was the first time. You really spoke really nice, because it is not at all easy to speak over Zoom. Public speaking is more of being offline speaking around for people. But then
I thought that I am speaking to my friend. Basically, everybody is looking like that. The environment is so friendly. So it was very easy for me. Thanks.
Exactly. Really, you did really good, great job, Rohit. And the story which you narrated was really nice. And ultimately, that you summarized with the conclusion, that was super awesome. Wonderful, Rohit. See you in the next time as well. Cool.
Thanks.
So we'll move to the next speaker. Karthik, you can go ahead. Karthik.
Yeah, Kiran, you're able to hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear.
Okay, let me share my screen, Kiran. Hello. Kiran, you're able to see my screen, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So today I'll be speaking about law of reflection. This is from one of the books of John C. Maxwell, 15 Invaluable Laws of Growth. And this was also covered by Vijay in one of the PIM sessions. Before I proceed with the reflection topics. So we have heard people saying, okay, you hard work, you do action, you put in tremendous work, you'll get good results, definitely. And we also know that experience is a good teacher. That's what we have heard. And we are, knowing these things in mind, we are very busy doing so much of work every day in and day out, right? So, okay, what the author talks about is something different, okay? Effective action with quiet reflection will create more effective action. In the sense, are you every day, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever it is, are you spending to reflect upon what you were doing that day? Okay, whether you can learn something, whether you want to change something. Evaluated experience is a good teacher, not just experience. Let's take 80 years back, there were tangos, the cards, the bullock cards, which people were using, right? And so some people came up with the concept of buggy, and they were working on the buggies. But what happened actually? Parallelly, there were people who were working on automobiles, which can learn faster than that. So did they evaluate the experience is something to keep in mind. And everyone needs time and place to pause. See, there is something called life marker and life maker. Okay, in this video, you might have learned something. This is a life marker. But how you take it and how you implement it in your personal life for your growth is something life maker. Okay, in good times, we usually don't do all these things. But in bad times, we wait for good times. Okay, it doesn't work like that. So pausing with intention expands and enriches thinking. So why we need to reflect and why we need to know all these things about reflection? First of all, you need to have a good intention. What is your goal? as I was talking in the previous book club. So based on that intention, if you reflect, you will get good ideas and good takeaways. So initially, I have seen so many people don't do this. Even I was not doing myself a long time before. Why? Because we feel uncomfortable when we do this. Initially, when we do all these things, no, there will be some pain. Out of, if you cross that pain, no, you will think about some dreams which you want to achieve. But immediately, your reality will come into picture. And this reality will definitely suppress it. But if you still pass ahead and go beyond that, if you are able to handle it, you will definitely get a solution. Okay. So these are some personal awareness questions which you need to ask about ourselves. Take some time out. What is your biggest strength? If you ask me my biggest strength, I like to get educated with life skills. What Vijay tells about that. That's the whole idea of PM sessions on book club. So I want to get educated and share my knowledge to others. This is my biggest asset. What is my biggest weakness? So what is my highest high? What is your lowest low? What is the worthwhile emotion? What is the best habit, worst habit? What is the most fulfilling? What is the most prized possession? So whatever experience, whatever growth you want to achieve in any area of your life, just ask specific questions about all this and take some time to reflect about all these questions to yourself. And lastly, see, nobody is perfect. Everybody has some or the other blind spots. Okay, so are you doing mistakes every day? Are you covering it? But who is covering it? Is somebody there to help you if you need? Because I am not perfect. I get so many doubts. I get so many negatives also. But I have, when I get any doubts, any clarity, any challenges, I approach Kiran. I approach Vijay. Who are PM sessions are there to help me cover my blind spot. Okay. So if needed, you take somebody else who is genuinely interested in your growth. Okay. Who is genuinely interested in your growth. Somebody who has already gone where you want to go. Okay. So this is some points which I wanted to talk about reflection. I'm done.
Awesome. Really, really nice sharing, Karthik. The personal reflection questions, sabko bhej do yaar. Sab log apna reflect karenge. Everyone should reflect their life, sit back and, you know, date yourself and start reflecting. Superbly presented, Karthik. Amazing. Great. So, Sahana, you can continue with your topic.
Yeah, sure. Am I audible?
Yeah, you're audible.
Perfect. Hi, everyone. I'm Sahana. I work for an investment bank here in Bangalore. All of them have spoken so much of detailing and so much of content that, you know, it's so many takeaways that we get from each topic. So it's wonderful to be here. Today, I'm here to talk about a very simple personality of India. She's a Deputy Community Commissioner of India. When we say she's a deputy commissioner, we would have an idea of she being maybe like a typical, a student with all the suited up and all that. But when we see people like this, we need to also know their background. So I'm here to talk about one of the very, very interesting personalities, Sarika Jain. So Sarika Jain is basically from Orissa and she's from a Marwadi family. So she's done her CA in first attempt. She's done her IAS and she works as a deputy commissioner. But what's so special about doing so many things in one attempt? We get so many people who would do that. At least if not all of them who clear CA, at least you'd find 10 people who would do it in the first attempt. But so something so interesting about Sarika Jain is that she is from a village and from a Marwadi family. Usually Marwadi girls or guys don't come out into this world of education. But she really had that thing of education and knowledge to come out. And the most highlighting part is she's a polio attacked when she was at the age of 2. So obviously her childhood would be really, really tough because so many people would, tease and make fun and imitate and all that. So she faced all of those. But she had a focused goal that, she needs to be apart from whatever the regular people are in her village. So, but she had a dream to become a doctor. She never knew that, someday she would be a chartered accountant because her relatives kept telling it's very tough. And she took that as a challenge to, pursue CA or IAS because she heard someone saying that IAS is also too difficult. But CA and IAS are two different things. But she took them as a great challenge and she achieved both. She stopped both of them, and she's seriously a very, very inspiring personality. So when I actually saw her whole interview, it was such a, you know, we should feel so blessed to have so many platforms for our learnings, for our education. I mean, it's really important. When she shared, I found the importance a little extra, because we get that value addition when, you know, when someone shares. So Karthik was just saying, you know, experience is the best teacher. Sometimes experience from others is also our best teacher. She spoke some very important, the crux of her interview, I picked up a few success principles. One of them was, how do we decide our goal? Do we decide with someone who's next to us? I mean, just a random neighbor or anybody in your office who's just an average goal, or would you decide your goal looking at a personality like maybe Amitabh Bachchan or any famous personality, or would you really decide your goal on what you're passionate about? I think that is more important, because when you know you're passionate about something, you put in your 100% and you do whatever in the minutest thing that is required for, you know, to complete that goal. So that is one thing that I took as a takeaway from how to decide our goals. And she said, we also have to live the moment. We always either dwell in the past or keep thinking about the future, saying that kal kya hoga, kal kya ho gaya. So I think we should stop being that and live the moment and enjoy each time, each day, each second. So that's what we say, right? One step at a time. So enjoy each step that we take. And people will come and go, it doesn't matter. But what matters the most is that how ignorant are you against the growth? I mean, how ignorant are you against all the criticism for your growth? That is one thing. And everything happens for a reason. So she spoke about a small story. I would just take extra 30 seconds over here. She spoke about a small story of Akbar and Birbal. Very interesting story, because Birbal was always the the teacher. I mean, the one who is with Akbar. So Akbar, for everything Birbal keeps saying, whatever happens, happens for the good. So Akbar gets tired listening to it, and someday he'll cut his finger. And Birbal says, whatever happens, happens for the good. And Akbar says, my finger is cut, and this is what you're saying. And Birbal says, it does happen for a reason. And Akbar gets angry and arrests Birbal into the prison. And Akbar goes for a hunt. And there, these tribal people attack him, and they try to manhandle him, and they want to kill him. So, but then when they see the finger cut of Akbar, they say, we cannot touch something that has a disruption. So Akbar safely comes back and he says, Birbal, thank God, my finger got cut, and yes, it happened for a reason. And Birbal smiles and says, yes. And Akbar asks, okay, that is fine. But I kept you in the jail. How is that good for you? He says, had I not told that and you hadn't kept me in the jail, I would have accompanied you and the tribal people would have caught me. So that's the whole thing, you know, everything happens for a reason. We just need to stay focused and work towards a common goal and learn each day, educate ourselves in the best possible day, implement the education, and whatever keeps coming will keep coming, whatever life gives us. But we need to actually do something different and encourage people who do it different and help people who are doing it. It's better to encourage and motivate than to discourage someone. So people like these give us a lot of insight to our path towards success. And this is what I learned from Sarika Jain. I'm really thankful for that. And yeah, that's what I wanted to share. Thank you.
Great sharing, Sahana. That Akbar Birbal story was, icing on the cake, because that is what, it got stick. Whatever happens in life happens for good. You don't know initially, but later. Definitely. Yes. Superb. And thank you. I'm also blessed that Sarika Jain really came to our platform and talked with all of us. And to give you information, guys, she didn't took any money as such. We all requested her to give that hope that as an IAS officer, as a CA, and apart, she was a polio, she was a physically disabled girl coming from very small background. So you can also type Sarika Jain in Google, actually, in YouTube. You can find a 10 minutes video, which is more than 4 million views already. So it's a very recent lady, and she is one of the great inspiration, and that is where we got these learnings directly from her. So thank you so much, Sahana, to share these learnings. Great. So we'll move to the next speaker. Supra, if your internet is fine, you can go ahead.
Yeah, sure, Kiran. Only audio should be good. I don't want it to be disconnected.
Yeah, sure.
Again. Yeah. Okay, I'll just go ahead. Yeah. So hi and good evening, everyone. I am Supra and working with an BFSI domain as in release manager from past 7+ years. So before I move to my topic, I'll tell a small story. Let's get what happens some time back due to some catastrophe in the in one of the planet, you can say. There were different categories of people, and let's categorize the people in this order, like the thinkers, the leaders and achievers, they were one category. The salespersons and the consultants were into the second category. The workers and artists were placed in the third categories. So what happened was they had to move from that place. They had to evacuate these all people to a different planet. Let's take that planet as Earth. They are from a different planet and they had to be taken to Earth. So what happened? This other people, the notion which they carry about this all category of people, they planned this. So the thinker, leader, and achiever, let's put them in ship A, easy to remember. The salesperson and the consultant in ship B, and then the workers and the artist in the ship 3, C-SIP, I mean to say. Yeah, so what happens then, this people plays a conspiracy about the salesperson, and what they do, they make the ship B move first to the Earth, okay? And because they don't want, they want to move away from the salespeople and the consultants. So this ship A and the ship C will leave later on. So what happens, salesperson are not aware of this actually. So they happily rejoice and they sit in the ship and they move on. And later on, the other ship starts. But the fact here is the ship B reaches first and lands on the Earth first, and they rejoice again. So now let's go to the topic and understand why it happens and how. So this distribution kind of thing doesn't matter in the fixational world, but it generally matters in our world. We human being and the way our society currently is formed, basically in the Silicon Valley, we have a notion that when we are building something, we have greater power, and the people who are selling, they're not great. So this is the thing which we always carry in our brain. So when it comes to making things, you call yourself a nerd, a developer, or a tester or anything. When it is about IT, you always think that you build. So let's come to, everyone talks about being an entrepreneur, starting a business venture, starting all of these things. And you are the only person who is going to run your startup. So you build and you did everything and kept it. Do you think the customer will come automatically and take all your product and buy it? Obviously not, right? So now you understand the importance of the salesperson here. So if you're planning for a startup, get ready, build up yourself up to that level that you are in a state to really sell your own products, or you should have the capabilities to know what your products talk about. So if you see, taking the ratio of America, the highest paid jobs are for the salespeople in this world. My objective of saying here is we should always have that respect in our mind. There is nothing like good or bad, or there is nothing like a category of nerd and a salesperson. So we always categorize as nerd versus salesperson. So it shouldn't be that way ideally. So the notion should be really removed. We should not call ourselves a techie anymore. It's not really a good way to tell that way. We should always say that if you are going to be a businessman, if you are here, if you are speaking, means you should bring up that talent inside you, that you should be in a state tomorrow. If your job is not there, ideally there is no other option rather than selling. It could be yourself. You're going to sell your resume. That is the thing. You're doing the sales thing first. When you're selling your own resume, means you are a salesperson, and we should keep that in mind. And that's all from my side. Thank you so much, everyone.
Great topic, Supra. I think most important, most criticized topic is जब selling का नाम आता है हमको बचपन याद आता है जहाँ पे लोग एक अंकल जी आते थे ब्रिटानिका लेके हमारे you know they used to come in our home and you know they used to ring the bell or whenever we used to go some mela there'll be the Britannica people, encyclopedia people, they used to start selling and whenever salesperson comes we have a notion in our mind, a paradigm, but we all do sell to our girlfriends, to our wife, to our parents, to, exactly. You know, to our job and to our clients. Everywhere we sell, you know, knowingly, unknowingly. So let us, you know, accept the reality and make our communication, make our selling skills super good so that we can take our words with us. Thank you so much, Subhra. Bahut hi important topic tha. Bahut acche se aapne cover kiya.
And it is from the book 0 to 1. I forgot to add that. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Peter Thiel. Very nice. Good. Okay, so we'll move to the next speaker. Achha, Supra, Bharat is around there. Bharat is there.
Sorry to interrupt, Kiran. He just went for the office meeting sometime back, so he won't be able to, yeah.
Cool. I think we have covered almost all the speaker now. If anyone is left, please do let me know. There was Pooja ka topic mujhe mila tha. Pooja, if you are there, you can go ahead with the topic.
Yeah, I'm there.
Yeah, yeah. Go ahead, Pooja. You can go ahead and finish your topic.
Hello everyone, I'm Pooja and I work for an IT company, and today I'm going to speak about fear and how to overcome it from the book Magic of Thinking Big. So starting with what is fear, most of us would have heard that fear is only an imagination, it's just in our mind and it's not real. Now after reading this book, I have a completely new perspective on fear, and I feel whatever is in our mind matters. So fear is a real thing because it affects the way we behave, the way we take decisions, and our outlook on most of the things. So fear is a real thing. It is mostly a psychological thing which stems from negative imagination. So we can say that fear is a psychological infection. And guess what? We have a cure for it. Now, before moving to cure, let's find out why we need to cure fear. Fear affects our ability to perceive things rightly. So we may not be able to see the right thing when we are in a state of fear. And it prevents you from acting rightly. Maybe you miss an opportunity. Maybe you allow something which is not right. And all these things matter. So it prevents you from taking the right action, and it wears you out, and in the longer it also makes you sick. The last thing, it lowers your self-confidence. So all of these reasons are enough. So we'll move to how we cure fear. The first step is identifying fear. Now with little introspection, we can all figure out what is the cause of fear and what thoughts are causing it. Once we have isolated the reason of fear, we have to follow following steps. I'll go one by one. The first step is we have to remember that action cures fear and inaction strengthens it. So we discussed last time, this repetition or auto-suggestion, whatever we keep repeating, we tell our subconscious mind it is going to happen. Whenever we take a positive constructive action towards our fear, it helps overcome it. And whenever we do not do it, we train our mind to like embed it in our subconscious mind. So we'll not be able to overcome it. So it is very important that we take action towards our fear. Now we have example, if any one of us has learned swimming, so the first process of swimming is in shallow waters, they train you how to keep afloat. Once you are pretty much okay with that, they'll take you in deep waters and they'll test you there. Now, the first time when you go there, it is because you have not experienced it. Every person experiences fear. But once they are in there, they know that they have been trained enough to work out there, to swim there. So they can be fine. That was one example. There is another example that the author gave. Like there was this person who wasn't performing very well in his job, and he had this fear that he would lose his job. Now he spoke to his friend, and his friend advised that he should act constructively towards this fear. What he did was, first he feared that he would lose his job, so he worked on getting counter offers. That was the first thing. And why did he fear that he would lose his job? Because he had to support his family and children, so he got an insurance. This way he was able to tackle fear. Obviously he did not switch because his performance bettered when he had overcome his fear. The next step is to, I just brief, there are 3-4 more points. So we have to put only positive thoughts in our mind. That's the same thing. You do not have to keep repeating negative things to yourself. You have to be positive. And always a reminder, gratitude helps develop positive thoughts. And there is also an ad research which shows that whenever we see negative ads, we don't remember it. And whenever we see any ad that has made us feel positive, we tend to remember it more. So this research helps us find out that our brain has a tendency to mostly remember or recollect positive things, which is why we can say that our brain supports us in being positive. We just have to put a little effort. So whenever we are stuck with negativity, we should just stop thinking at all and try to focus on things that we are thankful for. It will help us come out of negativity. And now there is another thing. The next step is, this is specifically for those who are who want to speak in public or say in person to people and they do not feel confident. We have to put people in perspective. We have to remember that other person is very similar to what we are. So we have to have that understanding attitude towards them. And we have to understand that we as a speaker are also equally important. And the next step is, we have to act according to our conscience. See, if we do not act according to our conscience, we'll have a guilt complex and it keeps on building and it undermines our confidence. So it's very important that we act according to our conscience. And there are a few body language advices that the author gives. There, be a front seater, try to make eye contact and walk 25% faster. These are all body languages that will help you gain confidence. And lastly, you have to smile. Smile because it brings positive thoughts and it helps connect better with people and it makes you look attractive.
Wonderful, Pooja. Very comprehensive talk. In the end, you ended with a smile. You know, that gave a smile to all of our faces. Absolutely. People who are not smiling, even they'll start smiling. Superb, you know, Pooja, really comprehensive, you know, you covered the topic. If you have the notes, do share in the Telegram group so that we all can benefit out of it as well. Cool. Awesome, guys. I think we are almost end of the session. Is anyone left out for the topic? I think Pooja is done. Rohit, Pramod, if you are available, you can also go ahead with the topic. We can take your last talk if you are available. Pramod. I think there are lots of internet bandwidth problem due to the rain and all. That is the reason there are less difficult people to switch on the video. Anyway, so it was really nice, guys, sharing everyone. In fact, the point one was, you know, don't narrow your mind, widen your options. Use this platform for the growth. And next week, I'll share you a few tips, guys. I have learned from my mentor, from Vijay. How can you look very confident? How can you be very confident while you speak in virtual, you know, reality? While this current generation is currently going a lot of virtual thing and even public speaking has become virtual, there are few tips which you can use it to make your speaking better, to make your, you know, speaking effective and without losing your confidence. And it might happen, a lot of you might have prepared, bolte bolte kabhi bhool jate ho script, you know, and we sometimes hesitate while speaking. So many things happen while we speak virtually, especially because we don't get the feel of it. But in the next week, I'll share a few tips, 3 to 4 tips, which will really help you to overcome this simple way of communication. And that way we all can, you know, be more effective and leverage this platform in a best way. So thank you so much, guys. In case you have any questions, do reach me out personally. Or if you want to speak something, if you want to share something right now, we have a couple of minutes or else we'll end up. So if anyone want to speak personally, I think a few, any new guy we didn't forget to introduce? I think everyone we've introduced.
I just wanted to thank you everyone for joining us and a great thank you to Supra and Varath. Because I know time, keeping a track of time once I did it was very tough. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. And it was a lot of nice
for you and Kiran.